Hi everyone, this is Dr. Mike, host of the free iTunes podcast, Psychiatric Secrets Revealed with Dr. Mike, but that's not why I'm here today. This is another Saving Savvy episode, actually a Photography 101 episode, and this one is on what lenses to bring when traveling. And we're talking about casual traveling, not necessarily a photojournalism trip. So as many of you may know, if you've been watching my channel for a while, I'll typically take a different camera other than a DSLR when I'm traveling, just because I travel with my family and I really have to be kind of quick and nimble with my photography because they're not as enthusiastic about my photography habit as I am. But I also know that many of you, your option will be either your DSLR, which will take excellent pictures, or your cell phone, which will take so-so pictures, so you're really going to take that DSLR. And you might be at the point in your hobby where you're starting to build a lens collection. So that's what we're going to talk about today. So the first lens that I would recommend that you get would be a prime lens. And pretty much all camera manufacturers sell very inexpensive 35mm and 50mm prime lenses. This particular one has an aperture of 1.8. So this is going to be usable in pretty dim light with your DSLR. And so if you're taking a lot of photos, let's say night at dinner, or maybe you're going to tour some historic dark places like churches, or that really don't want you flashing, or perhaps you're going to be using this in museums, which of course will not allow you to flash, these kinds of lenses come in handy. So 35 or 50 millimeters are great, inexpensive lenses, and I would choose the lens based on how often you think you would use it after the trip. So 50 millimeter is great for if you're doing a lot of just indoor photography or portrait photography without a flash, and the 35 millimeter version would be a little bit better if you planned on doing more street type photography. Although they're close enough in focal lengths that they're kind of interchangeable, but the 35 millimeter will give you a little wider angle of view, 50 a little more tighter. The other lens that I would recommend is what's called a travel zoom. So I have one here. This one's by Sigma, but here again, your camera manufacturer will have a version of this, as will companies like Tamron. So Sigma makes mounts for all different sorts of cameras. And so this particular one goes from 17... Oops, that's not the right lens. This, I was going to show you that later. This particular one, which looks almost identical, but it's not, goes from 18 to 250 millimeters. So this is going to go to a fairly wide angle down to a pretty nice telephoto. And this is crop censored, so you have to take that into account too. So that even will get you a little further. Now, when looking at these lenses, you might be tempted to go for the highest number on top, the most telephoto. But really, the difference between 200 and 250 millimeters is not that great. However, there's a huge difference between, let's say, 18 and 28 millimeters. So 18 is going to give you a much wider field of view than 28 millimeters. So try to go for a low number down here. Up here, a little bit less important. Now, these lenses will have better optical qualities than your kit lens, but of course, they're not going to compete with prime lenses or professional level lenses, but they'll take awesome pictures. Remember, if your camera does not have inboard image stabilization, that you definitely want to get a lens that has image stabilization, especially on that telephoto lens, because even a small movement in your hand will translate to a gigantic movement at 200 or even further more focal length. Now that's actually less important for the 50 or the 35. You can just use good techniques and often compensate because those lenses have the vibration is not going to be as apparent. So those are the two types of lenses that I would recommend. Again, you could take gigantic professional level lenses, but you will regret it. And these particular lenses have a lot of utility when you get home from your kids' sporting events to doing some portraits to doing photography without flashes at parties and things. So those two lenses will be very, very useful in your kit. As a little bonus, I would like to say a little gadget that you might want to get. These are very inexpensive. You can get them on Amazon and probably eBay and from electronic stores. And this is just a little plug adapter. It has that little figure eight connector on the back, like you will see on the back of your charger. And this charger came with a very nice, very long cord. I don't want to really drag that cord with me, so I can get one of these. And now I have a much more compact unit for my luggage. And lastly, as a comparison, just to show you, so this is, in this hand, this is a 17 to 50 Sigma. This is here, you know, the travel zoom. They're about the same height. I can't get this right. This one here is a constant aperture 2.8, so it's a much better lens, much heavier, much thicker. This is the non-travel zoom here. You can see everything gets reversed in the camera. And so just for your knowledge, or just as a point of comparison, that's that. And so these little lenses, although they're not tiny, are really pretty darn compact for a DSLR. With that, have a great day. Please subscribe to my channel. Please give me a thumbs up if you like this video. And if you get some time, please give my free podcast a listen. Again, it's Psychiatric Secrets Revealed with Dr. Mike. Have an awesome day, everyone.